My most commonly requested video topic is carnivorous plants, those strange plants that consume other species, usually insects, for nutrients. So today I'm going to talk about a few basic examples of carnivorous plants. Most plants are autotrophs. This means that they make their own food, most often using sunlight, water, and nutrients from the soil. Through photosynthesis, they take in carbon dioxide and, using energy from the sun, convert it into oxygen. This provides the plant with most of the resources it needs to survive. But there are a few exceptions to this plants equals autotrophs rule. One is parasitic plants, a topic I touched on in a past video. If you'd like to check that out, you can click here, or I'll put the link in the description. Another exception is carnivorous plants, which, in addition to photosynthesis, get some of their nutrients from insects or small animals. Perhaps the most famous of these is the Venus flytrap, Dionaea muscipula. You probably recognize their clam-shaped trap with threatening spikes along its edge. What you can't easily see are the tiny sensory hairs inside the trap near its crease. In this photo, you can see them as the small, dark red hairs inside of the trap. It is the stimulation of these hairs that causes the trap to close, hopefully trapping an unsuspecting insect like an ant or a grasshopper. It then digests its catch with enzymes, and the trap will reopen within a few days to await its next victim. The Venus flytrap is found natively in the southeastern United States, where it is included on the IUCN Red List of Threatened Species. It is also a commonly cultivated plant, as the carnivorous nature makes it rather novel. If you'd like more in-depth information on the chemistry and physiology of how a Venus flytrap closes, I've included a link in the description to a great article by the Botany Society of America. It also contains some tips on growing your own Venus flytrap. The next carnivorous plant I'm going to talk about is the pitcher plant. Like the Venus flytrap, pitcher plants feed on insects, but they capture them a bit differently. As their name suggests, pitcher plants are shaped somewhat like pitchers, and they are filled with digestive liquid. There are several genera of pitcher plants, but these are in the genus Sarracenia, which are found in various areas of North America. The pitcher-shaped part of the plant is actually its leaves, and you can see some of its green flowers in this image. Pitcher plants capture insects by luring them in using smell, nectar, or color. Insects enter the pitcher plant and slide down its waxy insides, and then get caught in the backwards-facing hairs deeper inside of the plant. Finally, they fall into the pool of digestive fluid at the bottom of the pitcher, where they are digested by enzymes until only the exoskeletons remain. There are even species of pitcher plant, like the parrot pitcher plant, which will feed on tadpoles at times when it is submerged in water, which is a little bit terrifying. And finally today, I'm going to tell you about sundew plants, which are in the genus Drosera. There are over 150 species of sundew, and they function like nature's flypaper. Sundews are covered in sticky, glandular hairs, which trap insects that land on them. These hairs also produce digestive fluid, which break down their prey. All of these plants I've mentioned do still photosynthesize, and can survive without consuming insects. They grow far better, however, with a steady diet of insects, and can then produce more seeds. And there you have it, a few brief examples of carnivorous plants, which can be found throughout the world. Please share in the comments any cool facts you know about carnivorous plants, or ask any questions you might have. Don't forget to like and subscribe, and thank you so much for watching. I'll see you next time.